I know this, and Sukadeva Goswami know this. Srila Gurudev told, when Krishna incarnate in this world, Lila Purusottam, being in Braj, he was 10 years, 8 months. After that, he went to Mathura and from there, Dwarka. So after completing his pastime in Bhauma Jagat, being in Aprakat Vrindavan, he is thinking, Chirakal nahi kari prem bhakti dan, bhakti bina jagater nahi adhisthan. I am not donating prem for always. Without prem bhakti, there is no existence of this world. So I must have to give prem bhakti. And Krishna is not reservoir of prem, is object of prem. Who is reservoir of prem? He can give prem. But Krishna has desire, I want to donate prem bhakti. What kind of prem bhakti? So we have to know that bhakti is two types. One is Vaidhi Bhakti, another Praganuga Bhakti. Vaidhi Bhakti called Shastra Sasan Abadharana Mai. What mentioned in scripture, oh, if you not do this, you have to suffer. You have to go to hell without any hell. In this context, Gurudev told, when Lord Ram went exile for 14 years, fulfill the desire of his father, Maharaj Dasarath, Lord Ram, although Bhagavan, but is performing human being pastime. When he was in ashram of Agastya Rishi, Agastya is showing him everything. Agastya is so great saint, even tiger and goat, they drink water in the same place. They forget enmity. So Lord Ramchandra was standing, Agastya Rishi is pointing here, there. Then Lord Ramchandra saw one aeroplane landed in the bank of a pond in Agastya Rishi's premises. One very beautiful personality came out from the aeroplane and he went to the pond, bank of the pond. One dead body was floating there. He dragged it and he has one knife, cut some piece of the dead body, eat and again take off from there. Lord Ramchandra asking, Prabhu, what is this? It seems to me that it came from heavenly planet. Why eating dead body? And why dead body is here? Agastya Rishi smiling, oh Prabhu, you are Bhagavan, you know everything. You want to listen from me? You are happy to listen from me? Okay. Then I will tell you. Then he told, this person, when he was in this world, he never served his parents, but do some social work. Due to social work, he got some good punna phal, good activity. For the result of punna, he went to heavenly planet. But our first guru is mother, then father. And they are also devotee. He never served them. For that going there, being in heavenly planet, he could not drink amrit nectar or could not eat anything. The dead body is protected here. Every day he used to come and take one piece of his dead body. Lord Ramchandra asked Prabhu, how you can deliver from this situation? Again, Agastya Rishi is smiling. I have to tell. Agastya told, he had some golden bangle. If you take as a donation, then he can get rid of this very terrible situation. Lord Ramchandra, I have to take. I came in Kshatriya dynasty. I know how to donate. I never beg from others, never keep my hand like this. Prabhu, you can take your 70%. Agastya said, no. If I take, he'll not be get rid of this situation. So Lord Ramchandra, he took, then he get rid of the situation. So hearing this, oh, yeah, Lord Ramchandra took from him.
That person who went to.
Yeah. Every day used to come. Augustine, he called him, he came and he gave. Yes, then Ramchandra took, then he immediately liberated from this situation. Hearing this, if somebody became scared, oh, if I not respect my parents, I have to go hell without any fail, or must I have to do bhakti? So hearing this, who has some inclination towards bhakti, that called Vaidhi bhakti. But Mahaprabhu not came for this. He came for Raganuga bhakti, to give prem. So prem also, prem, not only prem, prem ras. He also two types, mukha ras and gauna ras, means primary ras and secondary ras. Primary ras divided into five, santa, dasya, sukha, vatsalya, madhur. Secondary divided into seven, hasya, adbhut, korun, rudra, bhayanak, bir, vibhatsa. And Krishna release all these things. But in Golok Vrindavan, oh, I release all these things. How Sakha love me? Sakha is telling to Krishna, Tumi kon bada lok, tumi amisham. Oh, what kind of rich person you are? You are thinking that you are son of Nanda Baba, he is very wealthy person. Siddhanta says, forget it. Your father has only 9 lakh cows, you are grazing, and I am grazing 11 lakh cows. I am more wealthy person than you. What do you think? They never consider Krishna is Swayam Bhagavan. They tell anything, immediately reply. Every day when Krishna used to go for cow grazing, they used to play quite a lot. One good leader, Baladev Prabhu, Krishna's elder brother, another group leader, Krishna himself. Their condition, who will lose it, they have to carry the winner one in their own shoulder. They are doing so. So, Baladev's party, loser, and Krishna choose Sridhar, brother of Radhika, sitting on his back, hey ghoda, chalo, chalo. Chalo, more faster, more faster. Sridhar is loser, could not speak anything, completely silent, and follow Krishna's and fulfill his desire. Follow Krishna's order and fulfill Krishna's desire. Again, they start a match. Now Baladev Prabhu's party became winner. Now Sridhar bola, main sale ke kandhe pe chadunga. O to mujhe ghada jaise chala liya. Ab usko main ghada banaunga. Means he told, before Krishna make me horse, now I will make me my horse. I ride on him. Krishna has no choice. So Sridhar ride on Krishna's back. Oh my ghoda, chalo, chalo, more faster, more faster. And Krishna is silent. Then after going some distance, Krishna faster and dropped him, ran away. Sridhar has took his charging, grazing stick. Sale kahan bhagega? Kahan bhagega tu? Idhar Maya Jashoda nahi jaake tu mukh chhipa lega? Where will go? Idhar not Mother Jashoda. Will hide behind Mother Jashoda. I'll give a good lesson. Somebody has come, have to open door. Then Krishna thought, only Dau Bhaiya can save me, no one else. So Krishna ran as fast as possible, going there, grab Balaram Prabhu. Dau, protect me, Sridhar want to beat me. And Sridhar already arrived and grabbed Krishna's hand. Dau told Sridhar, he is my brother, his body is super soft, very fragile. यू कैन राइड ऑन माई शोल्डर. नो नो, मैं साले के कंधे पे चढ़ूंगा, छोड़ूंगा नहीं इसको. सो कृष्ण न्यू ऑल दिस थिंग इज रिलीज व्हाट इज इन सखरस. He go in deep, Vatsalya Ras, parental mood, divided into parental mood and maternal mood. Mother has much more love for their children than father. Mother carry their baby in her womb. When I was in Florida, one devotee was telling their one son, disciple of Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, Mahamudhi Prabhu. His son, when he born about 11 pounds, so big baby, always being in his mother room, always kicking, moving so much, his mother became so disturbed. Only she can control her son, he only used to keep one small tape recorder, touching with her womb and playing Gurudev Kirtan. Whenever that baby will listen Gurudev Kirtan, it calm and quiet. With other Kirtan, never subside. That lady was telling, that lady is initiated by Srila Gurudev. The lady was lamenting, weeping in front of me. I am missing so much to Gurudev, I don't know how you are maintaining your life. Like, due to politics of ISKCON, I could not come to Gurudev so earlier. And he told this fact. Well, only when I too much disturbed, then I start the tape. And then they become and quiet. All of other devotees continued asking, what you are doing? Well, I never told, disclose this. So, what is in Gurudev's kirtan? How much power? Ramchandra telling is not from this world. He came from other world. Why you delivered us? Even that lady does not, he knows Gurudev, but never seen as before. That boy, who has come this boy? Boy does not know anything, only that tape is silent. So, Vatsalya Ras, two types, paternal and maternal. Mother has so much love for baby. So, Mother Yashoda always nourishing Krishna. Early morning, when Krishna woke up, Mother Yashoda came to woke up Krishna along with Rohini Devi, Jogmaya Purnamasi Devi and Mukhara Devi, grandmother of Radhika, mothers of mother of Radhika, and Krishna's two nurses, Ambika and Kilimba. Mother Yashoda came and telling, Utho Lala Mukh Dholo, Utho Lala Aakhe Kholo, Pani Lai Mukh Dholo. Oh my dear son, get up, get up. Now time for look up and wash your hand and face. But Krishna is deep sleep. Who told this? Is telling by Madhurika Devi, one Radhika Sakhi. When Radhika is there, Lolita, Visakha, all other Sakhis are there, one Sakhi came. Radhika asked, oh Madhurika, from where you are coming? Madhurika told, today early morning I went to Nandagram. What happened there? What happened there? Then Madhurika is telling this. Mother came along with these personalities, but Lala is completely senseless, like knows nothing. Mother tears and breast milk from mother's breast, giving abhishek to Krishna, but is not woke up at all. Then what happened? When Krishna woke up, what took place, I am not going details. Then Mother Yashoda told to Krishna, Lala, do pranam to Purnamasi Devi. Krishna being Swayam Bhagavan, did pranam touching feet Purnamasi Devi, and mother again and again taking feet dust from Purnamasi Devi near all over Krishna's body and near her body also. Mother told to Rohini Devi, oh Rohini, look, Krishna's head is spinning. You last night could not eat properly. Go and get some butter and sugar candy. Rohini went immediate. Madhurika is telling to gopis, which I have heard from Gurudev, tell it to you. When I am alone with Gurudev, sometimes we used to tell so many Harikatha time to time, so many pastimes, sometimes little joking, I used to joke with him time to time. So then Rohindri brought, he went to bring sugar candy and makhan, butter. I exhibit here. And what happened? In the meantime, Madhu Mangal came. Before Krishna woke up, Madhu Mangal told Sale, still you are sleeping? We are not going for cow grazing? Only you became tired? He grabbed Krishna. Baladev Prabhu came, then three sitting there, and Mother Yashoda feeding butter and mixed with sugar candy. Krishna, Balaram and Madhu Mangal. Krishna taking one bite, Mother Yashoda feeding by her own hand. Next to Baladev Prabhu, then Madhu Mangal. Madhu eating, it means taking air, opening mouth. Two times, three times. They are taking one times, Madhu Mangal taking two or three times. When it finished, Madhu Mangal told Mother, my stomach is not full yet. Go and get more. So he is going again and Yashoda feeding. In the meantime, one milkman came from cow shed of Nanda Maharaj, told, today something happened very strange. What happened strange? Krishna asking. Oh, today any cow not giving even a drop of milk. Expert milkmaid, they are doing their level best, could not milking any cow. Even the calf, they are sucking direct from mother's udder, not giving one drop of milk. Only looking towards you and mowing very louder. Then Mother Yashoda give one golden pot to Krishna's hand and one rope to bind hind leg of the cows. Although broad cows they never kick, but still this is the nature of cows, then they will be very quiet. And this Mother Yashoda told to Baladev Prabhu, Beta Baladev, take your brother, go to cow shed. And after milking cow, if you go to arena, don't delay there so much. If you will delay, then you will late to arrive in your house, then late massage, late bath, then it will so much delay for your father to take prasad. Baladev told, okay, no problem. This old mother, you advise everything to Dau Bhaiya, why not to me? I am the best polite. I am the polite among all the boys. I am the top polite person, top polite boy. Mother said, yes, I know very well how much polite you are. Up to now we are stealing butter here and there. So many person came to complain so many times, and so many times they not come to me also. I know how you are obedient, how polite, I know very well to you. Then Krishna told Mother, if I am not obedient and not polite, then how I can obey my elder brother? You are advising my elder brother, not to me. If I am not obedient, how I can care for him also? Next time when you advise my elder brother, you have to advise same time to me also. Mother, okay, no problem, go for cow milking. There's no end there. So Krishna told, I know the paternal mood and maternal mood. I realize all this and go in deep. In Sakhis, I know some Sakhis about this. Krishna was, Radhika Sakhi, Krishna Sakhi four times. Sapaksha, Vipaksha, Tatastha, Suridpaksha. Sapaksha means Radhika and her own party, headed by Lalita, Visakha, others. And Vipaksha, Chandravali group. Chandravali is Radhika's cousin sister. And Suridpaksha, Radhika Suridpaksha is Samala. And Tatastha is Saiva. So Krishna, everywhere, always tell to others, all gopis, oh, I love you more than anyone. By this way, Krishna, and in such a way, all gopis think, oh, Krishna loves me more than anyone. Once, Krishna was in Chandravali is camped. And by chance Krishna told, "Oh Tara, how are you?" Then Padma became very angry. Like Radhika's group head is Lalita, in same way Chandravali's group head is Padma. Padma became very angry. "What, you are insulting us like this way?" Tara means Radha. "You can insult other ways. Why you take this name in front of my Sakhi? My Sakhi is best, and you took one insignificant name. Go away from here." Then Krishna easily consoled them. Krishna is thinking, I can understand Padma's mood and Chandravali's mood also, I can go that deep. But Radhika's mood, unfathomable for me. I could not get its fathom. How then give example? When Guru used to Brajamandal Parikrama, under guidance of Gurudev used to go every year, who did Parikrama in 80s and beginning of 90s, the best Parikrama. Not so big group. We used to stay in Mathura, Vrindavan, Govardhan, Nandagaon, Varsana, Kosi, Kamavan, everywhere. And we used to, Gurudev used to speak only Harikatha alone. All you all, sometime you speak little bit, almost Gurudev 90%, more than 90% Gurudev used to tell. So whoever did at that time, they are very fortunate, they learned so many things. So in going there, Krishna is thinking, when Gurudev with Prem Sarovar, Radha and Krishna both are sitting together, along with Lalita, Visakha and others, and like Rupa Manjari, Rati Manjari, Raman Manjari, Rag Manjari, so many Manjaris, and Madhu Mangal, Subal, Sampirana Sakhava is there. Radhika and Krishna sitting next to each other. Radhika sitting lap of Krishna. Krishna holding Radhika, Radhika holding Krishna. Radhika's lotus feet really much more beautiful and fragrant than lotus. One bumblebee came and want to enter there to suck honey. But it's really lotus. This is not bumblebee's fault, more than lotus. Radhika, due to human being first time, became very scared. Always became very scared. Seeing this Madhu Mangal, took one stick and moving the stick and kick, chase the bumblebee far away from there. And coming back told, "Oh, I chase Madhusudan, he never come back." As soon as Radhika heard this, she became faint on the lap of Brajanandan Samsundar. What happened? What happened? Krishna could not understand. Madhu Mangal told Madhusudan is two meanings. Not two meanings, so many meanings. One is Madhu Sudati Yasa, who is sucking honey from the flower, means bumblebee. Another, same Vigrahavakya of Samas, but here means Krishna, who is testing or releasing the Madhu of Braj Gopis. Radhika thought Madhu Mangal chased Krishna away from here. She became faint in the lap of Krishna. This is called Prem Vaichitya. In Prem, the two, Gurudev told Prem, there are two pahalu hai, two sides, two sections. One Vipralambha, another Milan. I'm not going in details or technical terms. Virha four types, Milan four types. So, this is Prem Vaichitya. In Prem Vaichitya, sometime we have seen in Dwaraka Mahishi also, Queens of Dwaraka, but in topmost, in Radhika. Prem Vaichitya means separation and meeting. And Radhika's monopoly is Madanakya Mahabhav. Meeting in separation, separation in meeting, both there. Gurudev used to explain in Uddhav Kyari this thing about Madanakya Mahabhav. Krishna saw, being with me sitting on my lap became senseless. What kind of brain she has? Seeing me, Radhika became mad. Although I like so much Radhika, Krishna telling himself, Radhare dekhile mor judai nayan. Seeing Radhika, my eye became cool, mind became cool, heart became cool, soul became cool. But I never became mad seeing Radhika. And Radhika became mad seeing me. So what I have inside me, Radhika realizing, Krishna could not understand. So then Krishna thought, it will be better I can go away from Braj. I have seen so many times Gopi, especially Radhika, seeing cloud, that I have come, face cloud, decorate herself. Sometime seeing tamal tree, embrace tamal tree, and became happy. And I am here, he became so unhappy. So better to give up Braj. So I must go from here. This is thinking like this. After killing one demon, came in disguise of big gigantic horse.
Who is that demon, Maharaj?
Keshi Daito. So what happened? Krishna always going for cow grazing. One day Madhumangal told, oh Krishna, you always boast, I did this, I do this, this, that. Only you have the beak of feather and flute and pitambar. If you give up this pitambar, especially flute and beak of feather, no one care for you in Braj. The value, you have no value, value of peacock feather and flute. Then, okay, no problem. Take this peacock feather and flute. Madhumangal, yes, give me. Madhumangal took his peacock feather and flute. And Kamsa told to Keshi Daito, Keshi, well, I will go. So many demons killed by Krishna. Well, they are foolish. I will go. I will kill your enemy and come back. Then you have to reward, very big reward. Kamsa told, okay, no problem. Keshi came. And he heard from Kamsa, his enemy with peacock feather, flute and pitambara, his cloth. When he saw from the sky, this guy has no peacock cloth, but flute and peacock feather, maybe they are always making some fun, doing some drama. And he's not blackish color, maybe he makeup became fair skin. And not yellowish color, sometimes they're making drama. Because Kamsa told he must be flute bala and peacock feather bala. This guy must be my enemy of my master. Then he came and became very gigantic, huge horse form. And then he kicked through his hind leg, he not touched to Madhumangal. Only by his ear, he goes so far and telling, oh Krishna, this is the root of all evil, root of all danger. I don't want your flute and don't want peacock feather. He took off and threw. Take you. This is the danger. I thought by this I can get laddu. No need laddu. My life in danger is a life-threatening matter. I don't want. Then Krishna took his peacock feather and flute. Again Keshi came. Want to kick Krishna's chest, Krishna hold his hind leg and moving and throw and finish. Ram naam satya hai, satya vala gatya hai. And when he went, Keshi Daito finish, Krishna was sitting alone. Meantime, Narad Rishi came and told, oh Prabhu, how long will you be in Braj? You being involved in Braj, you forgot completely. You have to make Maharaj Yudhishthir king. You have to go for Mahabharata battle. You have to kill this demon, that demon. How you forgot completely? Krishna said, okay, so be it. When Krishna thinking,